I get up in the middle of the night, there's my little toes, and the little red pups, they pile up on me. My little guy sleeps with me. He'll whine if I don't let him get up there. He's so little. But he was taken up for his brother, because Ori don't like the big boy to get in my lap. That's this one here. And the little guy was taken up for his brother, and he'll snuggle up to his brother. He protects his brother and bosses his brother around. The little guy does, bosses this one around. And little guy, he's much bigger than a couple of fingers. And he was telegraphing at his daddy. And so his daddy, I had to threaten him to spray. You know, he don't like spray. So he went and laid down. See, big boy's laying there. And he likes his brother. He'll lay up there with his brother. Now, I can get three of them in my lap at a time. Very seldom do I get four. Because big boy here and his daddy don't get along. He's jealous of him. But now he's not jealous of little guy. I can't understand that. Because I keep telling him, he's the puppy. Don't bite the puppy. And then they'll snuggle up for hours on my lap while I'm sitting up here in the middle of the night, couldn't sleep. My hips start hurting and stuff, and my back, and I'll just get up for an hour or so and then lay back down. But as long as I'm up, here they are, just piled in my lap. It's funny that two black dogs could have two red pups. He is a fat little thing. He looks like a Dachshund. I come in back in their ancestry, the mini pins were bred with Dachshund and Egyptian Greyhounds. And then, of course, the Chihuahua, I don't know what the hell they got them. Everybody don't like to see the little white feet. They'll lay up here for hours. They have to be right up on top of me. Got them a little spoiled. They've had chicken and hamburger and what else, but now they need to eat. They had pork before that. So I try to feed them, and once in a while I'll give them fish. This fish don't seem to get along with Ori's stomach or little guy's. I don't know what it is. Does it bother big boy here or his mama? Baby girl. But it sure does mess with Ori a lot. And I've tried different kinds of fish. I just try to give them a balanced diet. I just don't really rely on a bunch of dog food. I mean, I buy their dog food because it's got vitamins in it, and I keep it down all the time. They'll nibble on it. But they like their breakfast. I feed them one time a day. Other than the food that's on the, you know, down all the time, and their water's down all the time, but they get a meal once a day. They know when I open the gate to the kitchen, they come in there and watch me cook it and get it ready. And I do rotisserie chicken, or I grill hamburger on the stove, and that's why he got so fat. And then I put four little bowls down, almost all of them identical, the same size. I started not putting as much in his food as and his mother's food, because they're getting a little fat. But it's hard to isolate them. I need to put them in the kitchen, put the gate back, put little guy and Ori in the front room so they can... It takes them longer to eat. I think that's... I don't know why. It's about the same amount of food, but they are just little bitty messes. His ears are cold. He sure does take up for his big brother, I'll tell you that. He don't like his daddy grapping at him at all. What if I could make it smaller? That's a zero, that's it. But that reddish color, And they were dark saddled when they were little bitty. Well, I better let you go. This is what I have to contend with when I get up in the middle of the night. I put towels on the arms, towels on the back of the furniture, try to keep it covered up because they lay on everything. He climbs like a cat. He'll get on the back of my chair. He'll get on the, sorry, it's shaking. Back of the divan, he lays up there like a cat. Well, I better let you go. I gotta see if I can get some more rest. I gotta go to the doctor at 10 o'clock this morning. But that's what I put up with. That baby girl, she's sleeping in her basket. Lori's down there with these full-size blanket and floor. And these pups, so they think, but they'll go out, I can open that door, they end up pouring down rain. Little guy will go out. But when the hoot owl, he hears the hoot owl, he runs and gets on the porch. I don't know where he's had, I watch him when he's outside. I don't think he's had a conflict with him. I think he's just scared of him. They're not big enough to get him. They're pretty small birds themselves. But now a red-tailed hawk or an eagle will snatch his little butt up. I wasn't too worried about him when my daughter's dog, before it passed, was Abigail. She was a big chocolate lab, and she took care of the pups. But she was old. She's about 19 years old. I don't know how she lived that long, but I took good care of her. She was about 14 when we got her on her last leg, and I gave her another 4 years. She was spoiled rotten, too. I guess it's just getting up and cooking them a meal and messing with them. I had trouble with fleas this year. My God, I've done everything I possibly could. I bought high-dollar dog collars, things down their back that the vet gave me. Finally, I ended up with giving them the pills, and I didn't really want to, but it sure did get rid of the fleas. And now that's, I don't know where I'd give it to them this winter, but this first part of spring, they're going back on the pills. Especially through the 3 months of summer. There they are, moving around. I better let you go. They're going to sit here for hours. Sometimes I just fall asleep in the chair. And they keep me warm. But I've got them rotten. His ears won't stand up. I can reach them. They usually fall down like their daddies. Well, better let you go.